position now for the champion. Throws a knee to the jaw. DJ's hurt. It's goodnight, Irene!
Reigning one flyweight world champion, Adriano Moraes, shocked fans across the globe when he finished the greatest mixed martial artist of all time.
I didn't want to like enter his game plan. I know his game plan. I just was smarter fighter than him.
He did as he prophesied yesterday. He finishes the great Demetrious Johnson.
Hey, goodbye, brother.
Oh, man.
Brother,
man.
Hey, brother. Hey, I don't have a word to describe you.
Oh, like, fine, dude.
Man, you're a legend. I'm a big fan, man. Of course, if you wanted to rematch, brother.
Oh,
I'm your fan.
It is what it is. I was trying to get to him. He's a longer guy. I'm short. You got cut with the uppercut. You got blasted with a knee in the ground. Doesn't make him better than you. You just got caught.
With a professional record of 20-3. Mikino has risen to become one of the most dominant fighters in one championship.
When you train hard, you've been disciplined, and seeing the end of this story, everything worth it. It's amazing, you know?
Coming off a stunning victory at 1X, one flyweight contender Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson is eager to cement his legacy and become the first fighter to hold world titles in both one championship and the UFC.
When I looked back at that fight, I was like, man, I should have sat back and chilled him and let him come to me. But you know what? That's why people will remember my name, because I'm always going out there to take risks, to put it all out there.
On August 26th, the flyweight king will once again put his belt on the line in a Titanic rematch against the legendary Mighty Mouse that will headline one on Prime Video One.
I think I will submit him the 3rd or 4th round.
Let's go! You have to him up. This is a goal.
I'm not the best in the world. I'm just the guy who believes in the impossible. I was adopted when I was 3 years and 7 months. My mom adopted me from an orphanage in Brasilia, Brazil. I think it was the first miracle of God in our lives. I was a teenager and I was a gang member in my home hood. I lost a street fight, so one old brother of me bring me to jiu-jitsu and introduced me to jiu-jitsu.
The Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu saved my life in Brazil. So saved me against a lot of odds in my life. So that's why I'm still like practicing BJJ. I'm still like putting my gi, come to train, learn with one of the best guys in this sport. That helped me a lot to improve my MMA game.
To pull him until I reach the top shoulder.
They smashed me, but I will be back.
Yeah.
All for the gram. You wanna show, right?
Sounds like in Hollywood, ladies and gentlemen.
So, Adriano, where are you at, Adriano?
I'm at Hollywood right now.
Oh, really?
It was a dream come true to come here.
Where all the stars come.
All the stars come.
That's where you belong.
So it was a good one, right?
That's a good one.
Canada. Pô, Marcos Almeida Buchecha was the guy, like BJJ legend, was the guy that I used to watch a lot in Brazil. He was crazy to watch live fighting jiu-jitsu. And today he's heavyweight one championship fighter and he trained at American Top Team. We train together, we are friends. And man, that's amazing.
You know, we know what is the best song of Buchecha to work out. You know what the song?
The Rockstar.
Rainy Man. I love this song.
Can you sing that song?
Rainy man. Well, he loves this song. I don't know why. Don't know.
I think I don't have nothing to prove.
But of course, I love to challenge myself, and DJ is the great of all time, and share the circle with him again, it's be amazing.
Demetrious Johnson was one of the guys that I love to watch too, you know. As a MMA fighter at flyweight division, had a win against the great of all time, is the dream come true. It was a KO of the year, you know. I received the trophy of upset of the year. It's so hard to be nominated in this award, and I was nominated and I won.
What a beautiful event, man. Thank you to support our community. I just want to say thank you for my whole team, for American Top Team.
Good. I like to train hard. I like to learn every single day. I like to pass forward what I learned. I think that's why I have been succeed in this sport.
Right now I'm gonna train with the one and only Ivan de Oliveira. Yeah. So,
the wizard.
One and only, Paulo.
My greatest teammate, training partner that I like to drill, like train together, you know.
Now we're going to Restaurante Brasil, have a lunch. No. I like to come here after training to recover. This is Jay, the guy who serves us every single day over here. He's a great guy, really positive guy, you know.
Thank you, Jay. My friend.
One thing that I think that helped me to have like my mindset in the correct way is, if I die tomorrow, I will die happy or not? Like, if you leave something special in this earth, I think if you die tomorrow, it's okay, you're gonna die happy, you know? I'm a fighter for a reason. I love to be a fighter, but a normal guy too, you know? I love to do a lot of stuff. I love skateboarding. I like to go to the beach.
Balance, man. Balance. Enjoy a little bit, you know? Now, let's go to the ocean.
Depression always gonna be there, you know, but I love this kind of feeling, you know. If God give me this opportunity, give me health to be there, I will be there because I love that.
Honestly, I always wanted my legacy to be one of the best to ever do it. There's nothing worse than losing.
The mistakes, you know, Adriano, he's very long, big. I was trying to get to him.
This is life, right? Like, not everybody's perfect. My career is not perfect. My fighting style is not perfect. I strive to be perfect, but that's my mentality. We still celebrate whether we win or lose. We celebrate just making it to the fight. We celebrate being a successful athlete. When I lost against Adriano last time, nothing was different. I literally came home, chilled.
Hey guys, where are we headed right now?
Grapple Club!
What are we doing there?
Grappling.
Yeah?
And yes. Sparring.
Yes. And sparring.
They're both the same thing. Training! Training!
Can you guys beat your dad yet?
No.
What if you guys tag team? Maybe?
We can definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely. Tuesday and Thursday morning, I help the kids, take them to jiu-jitsu, and then I do jiu-jitsu, and then nighttime schedule. Mondays is pads, Tuesday night is sparring, Wednesday night is off, and Thursday night is pads and drilling, and then Friday night is sparring, and Saturday morning is jiu-jitsu. When I'm in this training camp, it's kind of monotonous routine over and over and over and over and over every day. So that's pretty much the schedule.
Hey, go, 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 go!
With the running?
Yeah, go, 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 go! That's okay, it is what it is.
Get out, hurry.
My kids watch, right? And as I see my kids going through their, you know, Tyron's 9, Maverick 7, and I see my kids go up against kids who are way better than them, bigger than them, and they get absolutely destroyed, and they get up like, I was just bullied. I was like, that's not bullied. You just got beat. That's all it is. You're fine. You're healthy. We'll try again the next day. That's helped me out tremendously, because when they see me lose, I tell them, I'm like, they're like, I hate doing jiu-jitsu. I hate going against that guy. I'm like, so it's gonna make you better.
That's the first time Tyron and Maverick ever gone against each other. Yeah. I think Maverick won that fight. You know, he took takedowns with, you know, position. Tyron did get on top.
All right, baby, we going to, I think it's this way right here. It might be that one. I think it was that way. That famous picture everybody likes of me working in construction as a hod carrier. One of the buildings down here I was building, man, I loved working construction. And I also hated it because the amount of shit you would have to lift to build scaffolding, and my black ass being 5'3", holy shit.
Where that famous picture is, this is where the mud was, the big giant container. And we had it all fenced off right here.
15 years ago, I was building this building with them bricks and these hard working masonry hands.
Now we drive a Tesla.
The rematches are always a brand new fight. I think this is the first camp in my whole entire career I've done something out of the ordinary. I trained 2 weeks at a different camp with one of my ex-opponents, Henry Cejudo. I wanted to take a risk and go train at a totally different gym. None of my coaches. I've been fighting on the highest level since 2010, so what, 12 years? And now I finally stepped out of my gym.
And bring my other elbow to the ground.
Like, we know where Adriano's sharp, and we know where we gotta be sharp at. So I have been focusing more on my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu just because he is an amazing grappler. He doesn't get to show it as much, but the times he does show it, you see it's very sharp, it's very precise. Being pushed in all the areas in my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and in my stand-up, it's prepared me to go out there with a different mindset and to go out there and take this fight from Adriano. The biggest thing is I gotta make sure I'm prepared for anything. Adriano, he's known for running, right? Running all day long and letting people cross distance. This time he came out and goes, I'm not running, I'm coming after you.
Why he says I was running from him? I was fighting, smart.
Because that's what DJ does. He likes to put your back up against the wall and start going to work on you, and Rice is not allowing that to happen.
The stage is set for one of the biggest rematches in MMA history, as flyweight greats Adriano Moraes and Demetrious Johnson once again put everything on the line in Singapore at one. On Prime Video One.
The legacy that I want to leave is, man, that guy had a lot of courage. He never gave up. He always pushed forward for the limit to, like, achieve his dreams. If I beat DJ 2 times, like, in a good way, I think I can become the best flyweight in the world.
You know, winning a belt and one championship, the biggest promotion in Asia, it would just cement my legacy even more. Who the best?